It's been a long time that biologists and researchers are curiously trying to map out the links between modern human civilization with ancestral beings. To date, no clear pattern is being traced out. It's like a jigsaw that is getting complex with each piece added. This is Earthy Perks, with a new episode to reveal about some of the oldest human DNA traces. Guess what? Researchers have found that an old piece of genetics in the tooth of a cannibal. Can you even imagine? They found it in a fossil that was 800,000 years old. After carrying out detailed protein analysis of the fossil, it is claimed that the cannibals could be the supposed Homo ancestors to humans, as well as for Neanderthals. Throwback to 1944, where a team of archaeologists were eagerly digging the mountains of Atapuerca in northern Spain. What they found was a huge skeletal remain on their hunt. These remains were of six different individuals dating back to 800,000 years. The bones of skeletal remains were fractured, and it seems if they were cannibalized. Researchers conducted thorough experiments to link the remains to ancestral human relatives, i.e. Neanderthal and Denisovans, as the fossil showed some unbelievable match with modern humans. But all efforts of classifying the fossils to known species failed when there was a zero match. The new thing ultimately got the name of hominins homo ancestors, i.e. predecessors. The fossil as classifies as the oldest ones in the history of Europe. In the process of analyzation, the proteins in the enamel are now sequenced to break the genetic code. As the code sequences aligned, it turned all the tables. The thing that was considered to the ancestor for sapiens, that was some closest sister ancestor. Actually, that was not adjusting in the same lineage. It was sharing the same phylogenetic tree that way down evolved as humans. So, the hominins were declared as the cousins. All this was classified based on paleoproteomics, that is, the study of ancient proteins. In modern days, another technique that can support the research methodology is mass spectrometry. This process denotes the masses of molecules in the subject under examination, which can further lead to identifying a particular protein. As far as the human DNA is concerned, it codes for the specific proteins in terms of a three-code sequence and results in the attachment of specific amino acids. These amino acids, when aligned in a particular sequence, will express a specific protein. Hence, this amino acid sequence is revealing the nucleotide genetic code. Hence, this protein analysis opens a gateway for studying the ancient genetic codes that is otherwise impossible with DNA. DNA is prone to destruction and could not stand for a long time. A real-time example quotes that, to date, the oldest DNA sample sequenced is 430,000 years old. DNA degrades relatively quickly, becoming unreadable within several hundred thousand years. On the other hand, proteins can stand for a long time. A real-time example is the analysis of protein sequence conducted for a genetic code of a 1.77 million-year-old rhino found in Manisi in Georgia. And another experiment was conducted on a 1.9 million-year-old extinct ape in China. Apart from the fact that protein analysis could give us positive results, yet the limitations also comes along. All because of the quality and quantity of specimens. The researchers also experimented a 1.77 million-year-old molar sample taken from a fossil Homo erectus, an ancient human ancestor that lived 2 million years ago. But the protein sequence was too short and damaged to give elaborated results about the specimen's DNA. This leaves us with a notion that our human tree is going to remain a messy bush. On this note, this is Earthy Perks signing off. Till next time, stay tuned and keep watching Earthy Perks.